Hello students, how are you? Hope all of you are fine and safe at your home. Students, today we discuss about our last chapter of Supplementary Reader from Mahatma Gandhi, His Thoughts. इस chapter में हम महात्मा गांधी के विचारों के बारे में पढ़ेंगे. And all of you know that the truth and non-violence is Mahatma Gandhi's weapon which he used in his whole life. Students, Gandhi ji was a devotee of truth. To him, truth was God. Once the Viceroy Lord Curzon said that the conception of truth had come from Europe. Gandhi ji took exception to it and wrote to him to say that he was misinformed. India's faith in truth was much more ancient than what Curzon thought. Now, truth had always been regarded as a form of God. उन्होंने सच्चाई को हमेशा भगवान का रूप माना है. Same as non-violence, with deep thinking, he has given minutest thought to non-violence. He writes, it is difficult to define non-violence. उन्होंने कहा non-violence को define करना difficult है. लेकिन जो particular जो कोई activity होती है violent होती है और नॉन वायलेंट इज ऑफन ट्रेस्ड, तो उस समय पे जो नॉन वायलेंट है तभी उसमें हम समझ पाते हैं कि वायलेंस और नॉन वायलेंस क्या होती है. देन नेक्स्ट इज सेलिबेसी. वन हु एक्सरसाइजेस कंट्रोल ऑन वंस सेंस थ्रू डीड वर्ड एंड थॉट इज ब्रह्मचारी. अगर किसी ने एक्सरसाइज से अपने सेंसों को, अपने शब्दों को, अपने विचारों को कंट्रोल करना सीख लिया है, दैट इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्मचारी. One who has not controlled his thought is not a perfect brahmachari. और जिसने अपने विचारों को कंट्रोल नहीं किया वो परफेक्ट ब्रह्मचारी नहीं माना जाता. Non position, thou shan't steal, prayer, health, socialism, language and script to untouchables, Mahatma Gandhi's favorite hymn. All of you know his favorite hymn was Vaishnav Janato Tene Kahiye Je Peer Parai Jaane Re. So students, here we learn about in this chapter all the thoughts what Gandhi ji whole life. Now let's go to the question answer. Question number one, why did Gandhi ji disagree with Lord Curzon's statement about truth? Answer, once the Viceroy Lord Curzon said that the conception of truth had come from Europe. Gandhi ji disagreed to this and wrote to him saying that he was misinformed. He added that India's faith in truth was much more ancient than what Curzon thought. He wrote that truth had always been regarded as a form of God. Question number two, how did Gandhi ji interpret non-violence? With his deep thinking, Gandhi ji has given minutest thought to non-violence. He writes that it is difficult to define non-violence. According to him, not to cause grief through words, deeds and thoughts to any form of life is non-violence. But it is impossible for any living creature to practice it. Many invisible living things are destroyed when we breathe. In the same way, we commit an act of violence when eyes are opened or closed. We may not kill serpents and scorpions, but we do have to throw them away. This also causes them some pain. Using various things for one's own sake and not providing them to those who need them more than us also harms poor people, which is an act of violence. We destroy life by eating vegetables to keep ourselves alive. Punishing, beating and rebuking children are even anger are included in acts of violence. Who according to Gandhi ji is a true brahmachari? According to Gandhi ji, one who exercises control upon one's senses through deeds, words and thoughts is a true brahmachari. An individual is trying to attain celibacy should control and regulate the things he or she eats. One should not care for taste and must keep away from artificiality and beautification. Those who have self-restraint find it easier to practice celibacy. Why did Gandhiji think it necessary to pray? Gandhiji had a strong faith in prayer. When he was in South Africa, he had started public prayers. Originally, praying means begging, but to Gandhiji, it meant singing in praise of God and reciting hymns. Gandhiji believed that prayer is essential for the realization of God. To him, truth was God. He told that prayer should be motivated by the desire for the realization of truth. He believed that all of us should be restless to realize and merge ourselves into God and pray to Him with the same sort of restlessness. Question 5. What did he mean by socialism? In general sense, socialism envisages equality between all. To Gandhiji, socialism is its true sense is present in unity in diversity. Socialism is pure and noble, and to achieve it, we should adopt good and right methods. Gandhiji thought it necessary for a socialist to have faith in God. Gandhiji said that he had been a socialist from the time when Indian had not even heard about this term. He added that belief in the principle of non-violence had taught him that all are equal in the society. Question number 6. Why did Gandhiji think that only Hindi could be the national language? Answer. Mahatma Gandhi thought that English language did not serve our day-to-day needs. He felt the need of a link language for India. After touring across entire India, he came to the conclusion that Hindi, which he later named as Hindustani, deserved to be the national language as it has the following characteristics. It is easy to use. It is easy for people to use Hindi for religious, economic and political communication. It is a language which is spoken by of the people of the country. Hindi has no rivals also as far as the mentioned essentials are concerned. So students, here we complete our question answer of that lesson. So you have to write it in your notebook and learn it.